a really huge network. So that's why Fire degrades it to a rank lower than 100. And I think that Fire is right. Those guys are not the ones we are going after. We are going after IPNAP, but not access for all. So, a case study. In September 2008, Atrivo was DP'd by his two peers. First by Pacific Internet Exchange, where what happened was there were some articles popping up in the media. So they said, okay, Atrivo, this is the American branch of the Russian business network. And they said, hey, those are malicious guys, so we have to do something about it. And it's, well, the word came to Pacific Internet Exchange, and they said, okay, it's too much, we repeat them. So Fire noticed an immediate drop in the mail score, and then it carried on for 1 week with the United Layer connection, and then United Layer disconnected them too. And the mail score dropped to zero. So this was a success story, not initiated by Fire, but monitored. And we hope for this success initiated by Fire. That's what the system is all about. So we have, of course, a website where we publish all these results. This is the blog, the status from, end of August. As you can see in the first spots, there is the planet. There are always a lot of malicious activity in. There's always a lot of malicious activity in the planet network. What else is there? Local web always there. OVH always there. So those are really big providers, and they always make the top spots. And of course, on the website, you can also do fancy stuff like getting the history for all the networks that I present here. You can rank by country. You can download the block list if you want for all the IPs that we found. And of course, you can also get this fancy map where we just put on all the IPs that we found. Well, little surprise here. Mainly, we see IPs from America, then followed by China and Europe. Russia is a bit misleading because a lot of the servers in Russia are in the same spot in St. Petersburg. There are a couple, and they're only shown as one dot here. They are also pretty malicious. So this was the part two of this talk on Fire. So summarized for the whole Wombat project, we have to say that attack attribution is an emerging field. And the thing is, it is tough. It requires a multidisciplinary approach and international collaboration. What we need urgently is stable, representative data sets. And, well, here's my invitation to you. If you want to help us make the internet a safer place, everybody is welcome to host an SGNet sensor and benefit from the data set. Of course, the more sensors we get, the more we know, the more we can counter those attacks. It's actually pretty easy to set up an SGNet sensor. What you need is just four IP addresses, a very old computer, and you have to sign an NDA. In response, what you get is the access to the data sets that we already have. You will get the data mining tools that we developed, and we have the web interface, and you can share the interesting results with us. Okay, and that concludes my talk. Thank you for your attention.
Any questions?
You spoke about different systems to detect all the attacks. Do you have a few information about the types of honeypots you used?
The honeypots? Yes, we have the honeypots in the SGNets, but for Fire, we have the client honeypot, the capture HPC that I mentioned before. So this is basically the only honeypot that we have. All the rest is what we get from Anubis are samples that are automatically uploaded by other honeypots. So we have corporations, for example, Nepenthes has a module that automatically uploads to Anubis. So if you download a Nepenthes installation, For example, from your Linux distribution, you install it, you activate the Anubis module, and then you send basically data to us to Fire via Anubis.
Anyone else?
Okay, thank you very much, Andreas.
Welcome.